Hello and welcome to a new video. My name is Tevek Yuster, and today we discuss the use of fillers and reinforcements in thermoplastics to achieve a certain performance and strength level. Okay, let us get started. First of all, to start with some definitions, and one important definition is the aspect ratio, of additives. And you can see here on the left a sketch of a fiber with a diameter D and a length L, and the aspect ratio of this part is L divided by D. And when you think now of a ellipse which has the sides all with the length of 1, so it's aspect ratio 1 to 1, meaning that it is a circle. So this is an easy way to remember, and the more you change it, the more you get then a more such a fiber structure. Okay, so when we go now into the fillers to start with the classification, what we can choose from are, for example, glass beads. Here we have the example aspect ratio is 1, where all sides have the same length. Then there is clay, which is more a platy structure, so the aspect ratio is already changing, is still considered as a filler. Calcium carbonate, also well known, has also platy structure, as well as talc. So these are fillers which are used to for example, improve the economic situation of a certain polymer, so you can make materials then cheaper without losing too much of the mechanical properties. However, on the other hand, you're also not gaining so much, so we will see that later in the comparison. When we continue, the gap between filler and reinforcement is in a transition. So there, for example, we have wollastonite, mica and milled glass. So for example, milled glass is already more fibrous in geometry, mica, these are flakes. So they are not matching yet the one of the two filler or reinforcement category. And then in the last one, reinforcement, here we have two examples, glass fiber and carbon fiber, which are both fibrous in geometry and have an aspect ratio with 40, 50 plus. Okay, so now we got to know some of fillers, reinforcement, and also the transition in between. What are now the main differences between a filler and a reinforcement? So let's start again with the filler. With a filler, we can have shrink and warpage control of a polymer. Especially when we mix it then with glass fibers, we can have good mechanical properties plus have a low shrinkage and warpage. In terms of strength, we don't gain so much, a bit of modulus. Impact resistance is for most polymer with filler decreasing, and heat distortion is slightly increasing. Then other picture we have with reinforcements. So there we can gain in strength, we can gain in modulus, and we can gain in heat distortion. However, with impact resistance, we have this opposite behavior. So when you have brittle resins with reinforcement, they get more tough, and when you have tough resins with reinforcement, they get more brittle. So this you have to keep in mind. Okay, let us have a look now at the example. Here I've selected a polyamide 66, and now we start with an unfilled version of the PA66, and I have some properties here listed, mainly mold shrinkage, tensile strength, flexural modulus, notched isot, impact and the heat distortion temperature or heat deflection temperature at 1.8 megapascal. And we can see we have moderate levels, so tensile strength 75 megapascal, flexural modulus is also okay, notched isot and HDT, you see it's just 70 degrees. So now we take the same base resin and add some filler, in this case 30% volume percent talc. So what we notice that we have some changes in the mold shrinkage, so improvement. We the tensile strength level, they are the same. However, the flexural modulus, there we see already some change. So we can double here. However, there you see already with the filler and the impact behavior, we have a decrease. However, on the other hand, on the thermals, on the HDT, we have a really increase from 70 to 205 degrees C. And this makes already for during your material selection process, can make already a difference for the thermal and mechanical properties. And now when we take now 40% reinforcement, in this case glass fiber, we can change all the other properties as well. So for example, in tensile strength, we can really now more than double it. In terms of flexural modulus, we can also more than triple it, so from 2750 to 11,000. Then the impact, so here we gain really also almost triple compared to the unfilled. And also interesting, in the HDT we can also increase towards 250 degrees C, so even better. So depending now on your requirement profile, you can go with an unfilled configuration or with a filler or with a reinforcement, or of course also the combination filler and reinforcement to further degrees and control mold shrinkage and warpage. Okay, if you want to find out more information on polymer engineering topics, I highly recommend you my blog findoutaboutplastics.com, as well as on material selection, my online courses. I will link you both the blog and the online courses in the description below. Okay, which video to watch next? In this video we discuss the consideration of continuous heat exposure, the UL746B. So check it out. Thank you for watching and do not forget to subscribe and smash that like button. Till next time. Bye.